party here is in full swing, and Cascading Springs Cottage is clearly the worse for wear for it. A harried housemaid waits on the raucous satyrs. The maid tells you why the satyrs refuse to leave. Lord Arden promised them that they could stay at Cascading Springs Cottage until their revels were over, and the satyrs have no intention of ending their party. The gardener says he left some magic seeds inside the conservatory, seeds that instantly grow into giant, sprawling weeds. The cook tells you that Lord Arden hid the key to the spring house. That way the satyrs wouldn't find his fresh golden powder. She has no idea where the key is now. A satyr calls to you as you enter the courtyard.
Hello there. Welcome to our revels. There's food in the kitchen and drink, well, everywhere. Including the floor, I see. And make yourself at home. And don't forget to pour one out for our dear host, to Lord Arden. May his slumbers be peaceful.
You attempt to take the sign, but are spotted by the attentive satyrs before you can pry it loose.
What are you up to then?
Surely you aren't letting your light fingers make off with our host's fine furnishings.
It's surprising to find a large, well-stocked library in a house given over to an endless party. It's even more surprising to find a sphinx sitting in the middle of it. The librarian tells you that you could end the party if you could somehow make it so that Cascading Springs Cottage was no longer Cascading Springs Cottage. Then Lord Arden's deal with the satyrs would no longer apply. This large key is labeled Spring House. It seems someone was trying to hide it. The lush collection of potted plants suggests that someone is the researcher. A note next to the sack of seeds reads, Slakeweed. Keep away from sunlight and damp soil. You drop a few of the magic seeds on the ground. Huge weeds burst from the earth, and the thirsty plants quickly drain the moisture from the surrounding soil. You attempt to take the sign, but are spotted by the attentive satyrs before you can pry it loose.
What are you up to, then?
Surely you aren't letting your light fingers make off with our host's fine furnishings.
Water gushes up from the ground in one corner of the room, forming a large pool. This must be the cascading spring the house is named after. This large barrel is marked Flashboom Powder in large letters. In even larger letters below are the words, Keep away from open flame. The twisting brambles suck up every drop of water nearby, leaving Cascading Springs dry as a bone. The librarian fixes you with a steely gaze, then issues a stern warning not to mishandle the library's fixtures. The master of the revels is not convinced by your argument.
The spring may be dry, to be sure, but this is still Cascading Springs Cottage. Why, it said so right on the sign. The careless satyr swings his torch too close to the powder keg, which explodes in a shower of sparks. The partygoers turn to gawk at the spectacle.
It's a simple task to remove the sign. The satyrs are still distracted by the recent fireworks. You deftly replace the cottage sign with the sign from the library. Seething with anger, the master of the revels reluctantly agrees to leave. The revels have finally ended, and not in a way the satyrs expected.